Well, all right, guys. So as I said, today's topic is about passing guard, and I want to demystify. I want to make it not so scary. Jesse,
I'm ready.
On your back. We're gonna start very basic. You might find yourself in a spider guard. Okay. I want to make it as not complicated, as not scary as you can, okay? Right now, Jesse is connected to me. Right now, Jesse is in control of me. I'm his puppet right now. My job is to disconnect from him and make my own connections, okay? So then I need to make some grips. If I can go here or here, there's many ways we can disconnect. We can go up, right? Or we can step back. We can always disconnect and push down. Now we have option. Shoulder of justice, or we can put him back on his back into this position we're very familiar with. This is not a bad spot to be. Okay? He's connected. Make your grips, step back, push down, put his feet on the mat. Now drive back forward and control and look at where my elbow landed, everything tucked in. But this knee shall not to be there. Then we can try to go to this position. And back to here. And back to here. Okay? Spider guard. Hand grips. Connection. Disconnect. Back into position. Okay? I'm stuck. Let's disconnect them. Let's make our connections. I'm in control here. Any questions? Yes?
Can you set up in the headquarters position, he sits up.
Yes, why is he sitting up? I'm pulling him up.
Yeah.
So now all his weight is here. I don't want him back here. I want him here. I want him to me. I want to make this not viable for him. So when I pass, he is curled up. Okay? Alright, so one more time. Make your grips. You know, all kinds of position. Make grips. Disconnected. Reconnect back into headquarters. Get used to squatting, having your butt below your knee. Your butt is above your knee even a little bit. Uh-oh. Okay? Let's go. One, two, three.
There we go.
Have you seen Spider-Girl?
Okay. Oh, this way?
Keep going past the timer, guys. So, hold her collar, pull it in.
Yeah, it's just...
Oh, it's going down to...
Decisions from here clearly. He's the person on the bottom being smothered, right? One more time. Pop. If he's fully extending you this way, you can step back to get to headquarters. If he doesn't bring this knee back in, right, we're ready to pass. We're working on a passing a lot better. So this knee is always going to be in front. Pop, pop, and we're here in headquarters. Okay, pinch. Questions? go. 1, 2, 3.
Find you one. All right. Sign you whatever you want.
You can Venmo me.
Very simple. Yeah.
try to fix it all, try to make it work.
Deconstructing this garden. Okay? What I'm gonna do, this one's probably gonna go from here or on the bicep. Let's put the bicep for now. Okay? I'm gonna take one step to the side. As I'm doing that, I'm gonna wipe my hand. And I'm gonna drop my knee. Okay? I'm pinning his knee and his arm, and I'm breaking this grip. Pay attention to my right hand. I'm making a belt control. There's no belt. Grab something here. You need a connection here. Okay? Stepping. And then when we're done with this break, go back to controlling here. Okay? Then next, we want to open our elbow and walk to the side here. I want to stretch his legs open. Once his legs are stretched open here, this is my Alice in Wonderland gate right here, to a position we're very familiar with. Right? We know this position. Make some kind of grip. Boom. I'm stuck here. Open this elbow, walk out to this side to stretch. If I don't walk out, his foot can unlasso. And now I have some other trouble because he's gonna push me. Look at that. See? No good. I want to look that foot. Look at go, go put okay. Come on, and then last one. Right? As if I go this way and start to open, if he doesn't take that foot up, he's heel hooking himself as I'm trying to open. So he naturally he's probably gonna take it out for me. Look, I'm walking up to the side and I'm stretching his legs open. Once I have a rubber band tension here, walk. Right through this guard. This arm is stuck. It's not defending me. Last though, guys. It's not that scary. In two steps, you destroy it. Okay? Make your base, your control. Don't get topped over. Side step. Push your wipe. Pin this. Break this. Control. Start opening your elbow, walking out to this side. And when I control this hand, this leg, don't control the leg here. Control the knee. If I control the leg, he's gonna put that foot towards my face, and he's elevating this foot. Now my gait is closing. It went from 100% to now 20% exposure. If I pop the knee down, drops, keeps my this door open for me. And me opening my elbow keeps that door open for me. If I don't, now I have to army crawl down and right, keep this door open. Here, stretch. Now you can just walk through this door. Right down the middle. Hip through. Hip through. Last time. Make your grips. Have good base. Step. Break. Control. Open your elbow, walk to the side, and then come back through the middle here. Look for your underhook. Square up. See you again, no questions. Good. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Don't worry, man. Appreciate it. Yeah. Next time.
Walking this way. No, no need to sidestep, just shuffle. And keep
keep opening up that leg. But look, you let go of that grip on your hand.
Look at this. Look at this. Yeah, but I mean, not yet, but once you like actually start to turn down, it does.
Okay. Squat. Have base, control the belt. Nice. Great. There you go. Control. Good. Stretch. Now. Go like that. The more I walk out to this way, the more I'm stretching. This is my gate. If I'm squared up with him, look how much movement you have with this one. You can put it in front of my face, you can kick me away, but just walk wrapping around in front of my face. There's no pass here. Yo, can't be friends.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
Let's look in, guys. Some of you guys are getting stuck with the foot in the armpit and getting it out. Okay, we're all getting pretty much to here. And this foot is so stuck. But look, stuck, 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 out.
Right here. What am I doing? Okay.
Stretch them out this way and go back through. But we're getting this hook out like this. It's going to be here. Pinch the armpit already. And just turn that way. And then elbows already open. And just walk that way, stretch. And then back through. Okay, let's go. One, two, three. A little bit of time, guys. Got a lot to do.
I'm going to get one more point and you
have to do it. Yeah, sure. You
Right now it's difficult, Jesse, because you don't have a grip on the belt. Alright. You need a hold. This is very bad. Okay, so just stretch
your leg out.
I know. Yes, look away, it's out! Open that open. No. Open here, open this. You already have this. Keep your feet in the gate. Hey. Right through the gate! Boom!
Good.
This is an advanced guard.
That was great.
But if you're already 10% of getting used to this, what else is this? This is not a newer guard. Beautiful. So, moving on, I want to work from here. headquarters. Okay? Anytime we're in this position and we're past the knee shield, we can pass at will. And we can make this even more high level. Look at that. I'm controlling this calf here with my foot instead of just having this a free floating. Right? I can just extend him. I can chill here until I'm ready, until he decides he wants to do something, and then he'll come in first and pass. Okay? I'm leaning on a beach chair right now. Okay? I'm not here. This is no knee slicing. This is knee slicing. Okay? So, we are in headquarters. Look at this. Uh-oh, knee shield. We have things we can do from here. But if you're not confident in doing the next techniques from here, what was our warm up? Great. We're in the position we want to be. Let's say it didn't work out though. A lot of cool things we can do from here. The most simple one first. Pull, pinching, push, push forward, kick, push, X pass. Okay, we're here. This is a drill too, guys. Okay? This push. This pull. Pull. Push, kick, shuffle. Okay, last time. Okay, that's where I want to go. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. You only have 1 minute, guys. Switch top and bottom and keep going.
Yeah.
if I'm doing the shoulder thing, I'd rather do a closer shoulder. But normally I like putting my knee, because I like getting my knee right here and I like using that extra knee. But you're dropping your shoulder. Okay. Yeah.
Alright guys, we gotta keep the pace going a little bit quicker. We have so much to do, so much to go. Thor?
Yep.
Alright. Let's look in.
Actually, it's better working with you because it's more emphasis. You can really see what needs to happen.
That's a good
so okay. Sorry. Headquarters, guys. I'm here. So we just did the X pass. Here's another one. I can push his knee forward and pick my knee back. I want my shin above my knee above his shin here. Look, it's crossed. Pushing forward, popping my knee back. See that? It doesn't feel nice on his shin now. And then I just dropped my knee down. Why do we do this pass? Because from De La Riva, maybe he's holding my ankle, maybe he's holding a hook grip on the pants. Now, cat X pass. What can I do? Drop the shin, drop it down, rips that grip off. Okay? So there's two kind of variations that look very similar. It's this, we just did, or, if there's no grip, look at this. Windshield wipe. What am I doing? Here, here, here. It's a little different from the first one. Here, or you can go knee on belly. That's different from this. Two different things look very similar. One is a windshield wipe, one is a javelin. Popping, pushing, popping, so I'm above his shin. Javelin. Javelin is because he's holding my pants. I have to use this one. At least. Okay? That's one. And then the other one is windshield wipe. No grip. I just want to push him this way. Just want to push him this way. Kind of like an X-pass, but just like you're shooting, right? Duck walk. Stay level. Stay at the same level. No pass? Same level. Okay? So, 1, 2, 3. Two passes there. Javelin, windshield wipe.
Did Johnny Glenn got see that?
So the music goes, I think you're making friends. What are you doing, Mr.?
I didn't see it, so I'm trying to try it. You're still grabbing my leg. Right here. That's the one. In front of the jab. You're still clear. Pop up. Just a little. Push this forward and pop it up. Oh. Nope. Too far. Too far. Okay, your shin is big and special. So, please don't worry, kid. You
watch what all about. I can't waste it.
This is actually how I run the best. It's one of the original music fields. The focus is on the action points with the dance. So we're here at this point right now. So, this is great.
Here, connection to him. So connections. my fifth connection. I'm that. My
foot
out. I'm winched if I'm javelin. Even if I'm going high.
There's a reason I didn't put my knee on the
base. Let's do another 15 reps.
Alright, guys, just bring it in. Thor. So, a little bit of overview. Just so it sticks a little better, right? Make sure we're using this hand, but I'll just use this for right now so you can see what's going on. I'm connected to him, my shin, my knee is above his shin, I'm staying connected to him. And if I'm doing the javelin, I'm connected to him, I'm connected to him, I'm connected to him, okay? And then look, my grips stay all the way here. Now we re-grip after he's pinned, okay? If we do the other one, here, wipe, step. Okay? All right. I'm brain dead. What's next? Okay. Floating here. He doesn't have any grip. He's here. He's controlling. I can put my hands on the mat above him. Okay? Here. Okay, I'm going to pick my knees up. I don't want to drive my knee into his knee. Okay? It's a floating pass. You're pummeling me. I feel him stuck. And then look. Facing this way, pinching this arm. My knees, same as head. Total isolation of this. From here, we have all kinds of stuff, okay? Arm bars, triangles, all things all day. But I want to get here. And then if you want to square up here, that's fine. But the attacks are going to come from here. Pass. Floating. Nothing holding you down. Forward. Right above his shoulders. Your knee. It's pitching from the beginning, right? So it's there already. Turn. So my hips align with his hips. And then control. Control. I want to give him my underhook, good. Because when I pass, that's stapling him to side control. If I don't have the arm, he's going to turn away from me. Then I'm going to his back. So, that's not wrong, it's just, what's your angle? You want his back or you want the side? You choose. Here. So look, what's going to happen now? I have to go to the back. If I didn't have the opportune time to go here. Just understand what those two positions mean. Very simple, right? Just turn. Have a base. Turn your hips to be along his hips. Come out to the side. If you can do like a magic dust, or magic dust is like this. Like that. It's like here. Magic dust. Okay? Questions? This is it. Headquarters. No gears. Forward. Hip switch. Floating fast. Magic dust. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
I just feel the introductions in it. I'm sorry to keep asking that. I don't feel how you cut my way.
fingers.
Another situation, another problem. Headquarters. We've been working if we can control and pushing this knee, but his leg is more than just this pivoting point. He can put his foot and wipe my butt. Now, go do that. Can I do knee stuff? No, I can't. I can't get knee above his shin. Okay? On top of that, he's probably defending this by grabbing my ankle too. Now he's giving me two problems to work with. Now, this stuff is, I'm off balance, even if that, okay? But look, when his foot comes up here, this gives me a hole here. Okay? I want to do the best I can to drop my posture, I mean, drop my base here real low, and I want to shuffle this way, and I want to get my knee in that hole here, and go ahead, I want to shuffle this way. Okay? From here, now look, we have options. We can control the leg, and then use this leg to extend even more. C-clamp. I like that he's holding my back. Because as I walk, it puts